It is a well-known fact that lizards regrow its tail. It is really not a folklore. It really happens. Let us see how. Scientists have figured out how lizards regrow their tails, and that's good news. By understanding the secret of how lizards regenerate their tails, researchers may be able to develop a way to stimulate the regeneration of limbs in humans. To regrow its tail, lizard need to release its tail also, and this is done by a process known as autotomy. Lizard tail contain three stages for regeneration of their tail. First, autotomy, second, wound healing, and third is regeneration. Let's first talk about autotomy. Autotomy is also called self-amputation. In this process, some lizards detach their tail from their body. It is a self-defense program done by lizards to get safe from their predators. When lizards lose their tail, they detach it from their vertebra present in the tail. Vertebra are the 13 individual interlocking bones from the spinal cord. The tail lives from itself near the vertebra after the detachment. Animals such as worm, salamander, and spider can also do autotomy. Spiders do autotomy when they are stung in a leg by wasps or bees. Then spider leave their leg by splitting their own venom on their leg to save their life. After detaching their hand, a lot of blood is flowed off. So to reduce the blood, lizard use a process known as wound healing. Wound healing means replacement of destroyed or damaged tissues by a new tissue. Wound healing is done by every living organism. During wound healing in lizard, keratinocyte and epidermal epithelium cells around the wound site goes to cover up the wound. The epidermal cell close the wound. In human, four steps of wound healing take place. First, hemostasis, which is also known as the blood clotting. Second, inflammation. Third, proliferation. And fourth, maturation. Hemostasis is a process in which the blood began to stick to the injury to make it easier for wound healing. This blood also acts like a kind of glue. Then inflammation takes place. In this process, damaged and dead cells are cleared out with waste cell. Proliferation means new tissue made on the wound. When all these processes are done, then at last, maturation takes place. When wound healing is done, then the cells which are not needed by our body are deleted. This was the process done by human for wound healing. Now the part regeneration. After wound healing, a lot of fibroblasts make blastema. Blastema cell goes to make a new tail. But what are blastema cells? To know what are blastema cells, we need to understand about stem cell. In our human body, there are organs like heart and intestine. These intestines contain intestine cells, and these cells are constantly dying. So there are stem cells which become intestine cell. This happens in all bodies. Stem cell contain such power that they can become any cell which they want, like stem cell can become nerve cell, muscle cell, etc. These cells can become only intestine cell if they are present in the intestine. And if the stem cell are in the liver, then they cannot become bone or muscle cell. They have to become liver cell. Stem cell reproduce with mitosis. Mitosis is a process where a single cell divide into two identical daughters. But in stem cell divide into two cell. Number one, cell called stem cell, and number two, the cell which it want to become like blood cell or any other cell. Stem cells also help in many diseases like Alzheimer's diseases, heart diseases, stroke, burns, cancer, and osteoarthritis, etc. When wound healing was done, then these stem cells become muscle fibers, Schwann cells. skeleton, which make cartilage and bone. During regeneration, stem cells become only these cells. These group of cells for group known as fibroblast. Fibroblast appears to play an important role in wound healing. The group of fibroblast now make another cell known as blastema, and this blastema now make a new tail, because this blastema contain every cell which is needed to make a tail, and this is how a new tail is formed. Stem cells make fibroblast, and fibroblast make blastema, and blastema cells make a new tail. Once a scientist named Emler Butler has done a very remarkable experiment. You must be aware of salamanders. That salamander can regrow its whole arm using the whole same process of regeneration. So that the scientist has tried a very interesting experiment in which he had cut the rest of the salamander and struck it back into the body. And this made a connection of limb with the body. And then he cut the elbow, which means now it has two hands, and his two hands will grow properly using wound healing and regeneration. This was a very remarkable experiment. If you think, why can't human regrow a new limb? Because in human, regeneration takes a lot of energy, and our body doesn't want to give a lot of energy. Instead of giving energy, they just make a habit of using one hand. Now don't try that salamander experiment at home. Subscribe Dex Scientium if you want to see more such videos. We will be back soon. Never stop learning. Thanks.